an American delegation consisted of 300 persons each, and as the Soviet delegation, it had 100 persons. Roosevelt and Churchill met in the Ukrainian town of Saki, near Eupatoria, where
we crossed
the right. Yes, the challenge Stalin, the Minister of Foreign Affairs of the USSR, Molotov, you can see the picture, came to meet Elvis. So you know that three rooms of the palace were at disposal of Roosevelt. As for Churchill, he stayed in the palace of Aluka, palace of Count Vorontsov in Aluka. I showed you the prince you spoke in Paris. If we look at the map, the war and political situation in Europe in the end of 1944, beginning of 1945, we would see that there are two front lines about the war between Germany, questions about preparations, about Poland, Yugoslavia, and the questions about the countries of liberated Europe. The Allies decided that every country of the liberated Europe should have its own way of development, and I should say that Churchill early became Prime Minister of Great Britain, and in the result was studied, and during the Tsar's time it was his reception room, and you can see the wainscots made of oak tree, and during the Tsar's time the other part of the walls was hung, if I can say so, with white tapestry with golden embroidery. But the tapestry was destroyed during the last war, and especially on orders of Stalin, it was dressed in with red velvet. And of course, this chandelier has drawn your attention. It's an original, authentic chandelier. In the other pictures, you can see pictures of Roosevelt delivering a speech on the results. Stamps, and among the stamps were very rare stamps, and one of those was this mirror in mahogany frame, the fireplace, all the fireplaces are authentic, and that's all. Well, and now we will see Roosevelt's dining room. They decided to sign it before to let it out, but they chose to begin to talk. But then came Roosevelt and then Stalin. The weather on the last day of the conference on the 11th of February was unusually warm. It was 17 degrees above zero. And someone from the delegations and two big armchairs were brought from the garden floor, from the dining room, to stop here in the yard all over the world. It was taken here in the patio of the palace in Lavidia. Because we have to go through the hall upstairs. Well, just a couple of words about this Arabian inner yard. It was decorated. It has a certain oriental touch. And this Italian, the rooms of the palace, they overlook. You can see some typical pieces of furniture of the Russian palaces of the 19th century, and the table, armchairs, and the chairs, and and a part of the wardrobe has survived till our days. Just behind you can see it's made of fumed oak. It has survived by Persian masters, and it's a present of it was a present of the Persian Shah to Nicholas II, also in 1913. And you can see Nicholas II, his wife, a German princess, Alexandra Fyodorovna. She was baptized as Alexandra Fyodorovna, and their son, Crown Prince Alexei.
The fate of this tapestry is rather uncommon. It disappeared after the October Revolution from the palace, and only in 1992, a Soviet writer, Ivan Semyonov, found it at one of the auctions in Germany. And he asked the patron of arts, Baron Feitzain, who was Russian by origin, to buy this tapestry and to give it back to Russia as a present. The Baron agreed, bought it for $35,000, and now this palace again decorates the wall of the study.